A lot has been made of the housing crisis in mainstream media. With the credit crunch and the dwindling economy, we're in a time of record levels of housing stress. So what's the solution rarely mentioned? Squat. With property owners sitting on land value, saving up to renovate, and waiting years for council approvals, industrious artists, apprentices, and students struggling to afford adequate housing have taken action to fulfill a basic need, with positive outcomes for the owner and the neighbourhood. Let's go meet these people.
My name's Steve, and at the moment I'm doing a first year cookery apprenticeship.
My name's Tim, and I'm a music student.
Friends here call me the Jazz Cat.
And I do a bit of music teaching.
I'm a student at Sydney College of the Arts.
My name's Ayesh, and I'm a full-time student doing a communications degree at UTS.
Liam and Carl and another girl hooked up on the internet on a Gumtree.
Who all were first-time squatters and weren't really sure what to do.
Mm-hmm. And got some help from some outside guys who'd found this place for us. Yep. Who kind of help people find squats.
On who is squatting on Parramatta Road?
I was just starting work, I needed somewhere close to the city.
Well, I think most of us are students.
Yeah, I couldn't afford anywhere close to the city on first year apprenticeship wages.
I had a few things going on at home.
And just rent really isn't affordable in the city areas for students.
There's no like, I've paid this much money so I deserve this.
Made a lot of sense, so.
It's just everyone sharing.
Well, this place is like remarkably good condition for like an abandoned property.
But there's always little stuff that needs to be done.
There wasn't any like broken windows.
There's a hole in the wall that we're gonna get onto.
We just had to replace the shower head, and there's basically nothing in here except a few bags of clothes.
Water and electricity were already hooked up.
Change the electricity and water bills to be sent to us?
No, we're paying the bills here.
Firstly, so they might not notice that we're here. Yeah. And secondly, because that's kind of us taking responsibility for the property.
So we were lucky enough to live here for maybe 4 or 5 months until they realised we were actually in here.
I think the reason the owners haven't made this a tenancy property is just...
The inside was stripped of all appliances.
I don't know, some sort of exuberant wealth, probably.
Quite a few properties. I mean, they own 4 on this street.
So it's not rentable for the mainstream public.
And they came by and sort of realised there were people in here and got quite angry.
No, the owners didn't get the police involved.
They wanted him out at first. They were really, apparently, quite aggressive at first.
Squatting is it's a civil matter.
But then he said, well, you know, like, look, there's a lot of us living here, all our stuff's here.
And then they kind of calmed down once they saw what was going, like, that we were just kind of living here, you know, passively.
So they said, all right, we'll come around and have a chat to you.
First they wanted us to pay rent. They started discussing that and...
They're trying to sell the place next door.
He said if we do up the garden, he'll give us 6 weeks free rent.
We were kind of expressing that, you know, not everyone in the house would be able to afford it.
They got him down to maybe $200 a week. We'll start paying after the 6 weeks free.
Yeah, I think squatting's a pretty like negative word.
Oh, there's definitely major misconceptions about squatting.
Everything's sort of for the good of the household, and where there are never any in a household arguments.
A lot of the chicks are just like, oh my God, you know, that's disgusting. But it's obviously not like that at all.
Yeah, I definitely recommend trying to get involved with squatting.
Yeah, very much so. As far as, I mean, it was an economic necessity for me.
I mean, when we've got empty houses and people that would struggle to pay rent.
There's more of a sense of community, and everything belongs to everyone.
And there's empty houses that are perfectly livable, and why waste those resources?
It's usually not really impeding on anyone.
And yet, even if I did have the money to pay rent, I much prefer the community we have here.
So I think it's a pretty good approach to have towards accommodation.
So there you have it, kids. Don't let greedy landlords and housing bureaucracy get you down. Squat your way into the Australian dream today.